Hey guys, this is Agent Lozen. Legend of Zelda today, the Let's Play. I'm looking forward to this, and I'm also dreading this, because this is going to be a long game, the way Crystalis was, but also a very fun game, the way Crystalis was. So, let's give Legend of Zelda on NES a shot. These are my save files from when I was originally running this game in my winning tips and tricks video. But I gotta make a new game. Although I imagine those two are probably both at the beginning. What should I call this? Right. Got it. I was going for an early plot twist. Alright, first off, I followed a particular path in my winning tips and tricks video, and I think it's like a good noob path. If you've never played before, it makes a lot of sense. But I want to try something a little bit different this time. We're going to mix it up a little bit so that we have a whole bunch of gear right off the bat before we even enter a dungeon. First things first, I need a lot of money. And I'm also hoping to find some bombs. That'd be cool too. I usually sort of explain the gameplay mechanics. I've gone over it before in my videos, but your sword is always on your A hand. When you press the A button, you can fire your sword. Your B hand can hold various items, depending on what's in your inventory. I have nothing right now. It's cool in this game that they start you with nothing. You get nothing. There's no guidance, there's no nothing. Just go for it, that's what they say. Every 8th enemy, every 10th enemy that you beat in a row will provide you with a blue rupee, which gives you 5 rupees. I think I should have gone down south, because bombs will drop from blue, Octrox, is that what they're called? I looked up all the names, I did all this research for my, winning tips and tricks video, and I don't know what the hell anything is. So these blue dudes right here have a chance to drop bombs, and I need them. They help. They would really help right now. Oh, good. That's perfect. Alright, so there's the bombs I need. I'm coming over this way to that big money stash. If you remember, there's a money stash hidden behind a tree. It's like 100 rupees, which will go a long way right now. But this first, just for the sake of completion, I guess you don't even need this note. It looks like a piece of blueberry pie, doesn't it? It's a note. That's lame. I know. I'm in the northeast corner of the map right now, if you're curious. You can see in the upper left corner of my screen, it shows like my little green dot in the gray background. And in the very northeast, there's this like, it looks like the entrance to a dungeon. And this dude's like, don't tell anyone I did this for you. That's my phone. You know, I haven't had a text or anything all day. My phone hasn't made any noise at all. I'd like to think that that's kind of my thing. Like, my phone will always go off several times while I'm doing a Let's Play. And I'll always say, I should have shut it off, huh? I should have silenced it. Oh yeah, what do I need? I need, I think down here, I need a candle. That's what I'd love to have right now. Oh, here's another stash of loot. Money. A little more. You can hold up to 255 rupees. Oh, you dummy. That's kind of my fault, I guess. And there's one more, a few more rupees right here? No? Next one. So I've got all kinds of money now. You know, before I wander too far, let's go get that heart piece. You know what I'm talking about.
No. You're doing a bad job of explaining what you're doing, Brian.
Yeah. Right here. In this rock, there's a little cave that leads to a heart piece. Is it right here? I'm gonna bomb between these two. Bingo. Of course, and you'll see these shops. The old man's offering a potion and a heart. The trick is you always go for the heart. The potions you can buy. I think they're 68 rupees, which isn't terribly expensive. But the hearts, you can never buy them. It's either you pick it up or you lose it forever. So I'm up to four hearts now. Naturally, it's really easy to run dungeons when you have lots of hearts, lots of cool gear. I mean, you can run the early dungeons right now. Like, dungeon one is easy to do, even without any extra hearts or anything. But I thought it'd be fun if I could approach them, kind of in easy mode. I think this place right here, this cave... Yep, there's my candle, my blue candle. This is a bad price for the shield. I don't need any keys. I'll never need... I mean, if you play your cards right, you won't need any. So I'll take my candle. So my inventory's starting to fill out, huh? And there's some trees I want to burn down. You know, there's a shop. Maybe I described this in my video. There's a shop, like, right here. Yes. And this is the best price for the shield in this shop. And you can also buy hearts and the meat. The meat you need for, I think, two different dungeons. But I don't want any of it. I just want to show it to you. Did you think that was cool? Tell me what you think in the comment section below if you thought that was cool. I'm a bad YouTuber. Oh, there's another bomb. Sweet. You can hold up to 8 bombs right now. Oh, you can buy bomb extensions for, I think it's like 100 rupees. And there's a thing here. Here? Good. Come on. Good. Got a lot of money now. And while we're doing things, there's a thing here too. Good. I've almost got enough money for, whoops, I paused it, for my blue ring. I assume you guys know what I'm talking about. The blue ring doubles your defense. It's extremely expensive. Right here. Bingo. Bomb between tiles. You can land, your blast will cover 2 tiles. In case you forget which one it is. Now what should I do? I don't even remember. These are the winning tips and tricks, guys. We're just gonna figure out what the hell I'm doing. Should I go after the blue ring? You know, that sounds like a good idea. What hearts can I get early in? You know, okay, I'm sorry. All right, I've got a plan. Now that I thought of that. Let's go this way. We're going toward dungeon 1. I want to get another heart piece that I can now reveal with my candle. And it's sort of in this direction. It's kind of the west. Dungeon 1 is basically just north of your spawn area. Hmm? No, that's the wrong way. I always say, before I do this run, let me do some research first so I don't look an idiot and like I don't know what I'm doing. I was like, nah, I don't want to do research. Don't feel like it. I kind of know what I'm doing, more or less. Whoops, I paused it again. Candle. Let's go here first. I think it's the very top one. Bingo. Same thing, though. I'll put the fire between the two trees. Yeah. Thanks. Good. I'm 1 rupee short of my blue ring. I think it's 5 trees over. It's one of these two, right? Bingo. So the first dungeon is just north of us. And just to the south, there's this hidden tree with another heart. All right, so far, we've collected all the big hearts that we can get before we start anything. Before we do anything. There are 2 more on the overworld, but they require items from dungeons. From dungeon 3 and 4. Here is another shop where they sell the big shield for cheap. Don't want that, though. Maybe I can get a rupee? There it is. Okay. I need that one more. No, I don't. Let's go buy the blue ring. And I'll have a bunch more hearts. I mean, like, several more hearts than what you start with. And I'll have, twice. I think it, like, literally doubles your defense, the blue ring. And then it looks kind of cool. It's kind of cool to, like, not be the original Link, you know? Like, in Ocarina of Time, did anyone wear the other outfits just because they kind of looked cool? There are several dungeons that require, like, you know, the hot outfit or the cold outfit. Sometimes it's just kind of neat to, you know, it's a fashion accessory. Going in here, blue ring. The key and the meat are both the least expensive here in the whole game. This is the only shop like this. Several of the shops repeat themselves. But this is the only shop that offers a blue ring and the only shop that offers that meat for cheap. I think there's an exploit here where you can pause your game and then hold up and press A on controller 2 to reset, you know, to reset the game to go into save mode. And apparently if you save it while it's counting down, you can retain your rupees. I think that's how it goes. Let's get one more cool item. Anyway, I'm not going to do that, though. If you recall in Crystalis, there was also a cheat to, like, save you a ton of money on stuff. But we didn't use it. I want to play legit, you know, when I'm doing this. Or as legitimate as I deem reasonable. It's a little out of the way. I want to get the white sword. So, like, anything that gets in my way, I'll just be able to destroy really fast. Man, we haven't even started a dungeon yet. Haven't done a single one. We're gonna have the hot sword. It's the sword preferred by racists. Right here is another rupee stash. I need a little more money for arrows. I think those are 80 bucks. And then I need a little more money, I mean, if I decide to go that way, for a shield. Oh, I think there's a shop here, but I don't want to blow it open, I don't want to waste my bombs. So just a few more screens, and we'll have the Watt Sword, preferred by racists. I think these guys can drop money. I don't even care. Now, is this a ladder or are these stairs? I can't tell. I always wondered about that when I was a kid. As a matter of fact, I always thought it was a ladder, like some Tim Allen home improvement dude just like mounted this big ladder to the mountainside. And this guy's a little tougher to deal with if you don't have a boomerang or something. He actually deals a lot of damage per hit, and he's got a lot of hit points. He's sort of protecting the white sword. Alright, now the trick to the swords, there are two swords in the game, beyond your wooden sword. He says, master using it and you can have this. As a kid, I thought, like, there was a master, like a boss, using it somehow. Like, I was looking at, like, a hologram. But if I killed that boss, then I'd have this sword, which is utterly stupid. What's actually going on is he means, as you grow stronger, you can use this better sword. And by growing stronger, he means you need more hearts. When you're at 6 hearts the way I am now, you can pick it up. Like this. But any less than 6 and you can't use it. And a similar concept applies to the Master Sword, which we'll find later in. I think you need, like, all but 2 hearts. I think it's all of them but 2. Alright, so we are just loaded right now. In terms of gear, we have twice the health we started with. I've got the Hot Sword, preferred by racists. Additionally, I have the Blue Ring, which doubles my defense. So I'm in good shape. But to further collect hearts and such, I'm gonna start with Dungeon 3. Because by starting with Dungeon 3, I can get one of the items I need to get the extra overworld hearts. By the way, I never showed you... I never showed you Dungeon 3 at all. As a matter of fact, I went into it in my winning tips and tricks video, but I had realized by the time I made it to Dungeon 3, my video was really long. I think it was like upwards to 20 minutes, like 18 minutes maybe, 20, 18. Oh, I can use that blue letter here. And I'm like, well, Christ, I didn't realize it was dragging on this long. So, I ended the video there. I really pictured myself, like, getting all this cool stuff and really showing you guys how to do it, but again, it's just getting too long, so I said the hell with it. I'll cut it off here. This is the old lady. That's the girlfriend of the old man. This is a love note. So here's the chicken. There are several shops like this where they sell potions. The red potion is two shots of the blue. So like you can drink a potion and then it'll turn blue, and you can drink another potion and it'll just disappear. Whenever you drink a potion, your health is fully restored no matter how low you are. I can't really afford the red one right now, and I wouldn't want to buy a blue. The red's more efficient to buy than the blue. And I know there's a 100 rupee tree just to the west of me, like right over here. Might even, like, literally be right here. Yeah, there it is. And there was a reason I didn't want to grab it just yet, but I don't think it makes a lot of sense, and I'm too embarrassed to tell you what it was. No, I kind of thought, like, oh, well, what if in Dungeon 3 I, got all the rupees and I couldn't hold anymore? Wouldn't that be terrible? What if I can get that bomb? Nope. But, you know, honestly, in Dungeon 3, they're not going to drop. I'll have 164 after this. They're not going to drop, like, 80 rupees. So it's a pretty safe grab. Okay, we'll come over this way. Those are all the, I revealed all of the 100 rupee trees. So, I mean, like, from the overworld, just from those three moblins, I've collected, like, 300 rupees from them, which is enough to buy, you know, your candle and your blue ring and stuff like that. So here's Dungeon 3. Again, this is where my winning tips and tricks video stops. These big jelly things that are here, with the wooden sword, you can't kill them in one hit. They'll split into little guys, and the little jellies they split into don't drop any money at all. But these dudes have a fairly high chance to drop items, and you can kill them in one hit with the white sword. It's preferred by racists. I like that joke, I just thought of it. And I think every time I say the white sword, you're gonna hear about it. Preferred by racists. These dudes, you can't hit straight on. That's the only condition. So from any side, but straight on, you hear the clang. They also, I think they belong to the bomb group, so they have a fair chance of dropping bombs. And here's more. I'm going to leave it here in case I need it later. As a matter of fact, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to start using them right now. To the right of me is a bomb hole right there, and that leads kind of close to the boss. As a matter of fact, you'll pick up several keys in this dungeon, and I think maybe you actually need to use maybe one right here. But what this will mean is that by only using that one or so key, any extra keys that drop, I can just save for the next dungeon. Which I think, you know, is such a cool concept for Legend of Zelda, you know, for such an early game. Everything nowadays is so scripted. Everything you do is so deliberate, intentional, which is fine. You know, it wouldn't make sense to just randomly find things. But honestly, randomly finding things is how Zelda works. Just stuff just drops and you just grab it and... good or bad, you know, you proceed with the game. But it gives you so much freedom. Like, think of Ocarina of Time. Everything in that game is very scripted. Could you enter the third dungeon right off the bat if you wanted to in Ocarina? No. You have to go through every dungeon in the order they give you. By the way, I don't need to do this. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm killing them, that's what I'm doing. I'm showing you how good I am. Yeah, but you have to go through every dungeon in the game in the order they give you, and there's no other choice. There's nothing. You don't have the right item to get in there? Well, too bad. You can't go in there. But here, just, yeah, go do whatever you want to. Which is really cool, and in a way, I wish that there are more games nowadays. Or just, they threw you into the world, gave you some really basic instruction, and they just said, go for it. Which is what Zelda does. Alright, by leaving one orange dude, one of these knights in this room, they don't all respawn when I come back out of that little labyrinthy place. That loot room. So, I've got everything I need from this dungeon. I have my, the raft I just picked up? I don't even need that bomb. Yeah, I mean, you can get the map, you can get the compass to reveal the location of the dungeon's boss. But you don't need it. I forgot which way to go again. Here's the map. Sweet. You have to enter in from the south. If I remember the room right. I'm pretty sure you do. So I'm gonna kill these dudes, it's gonna open the door. I kind of explained that some rooms the door only opens when you kill all the guys in the room. I mean, I sort of assume, or maybe that's not fair, I kind of assume that you've watched my winning tips and tricks video, and you have like a ton of time to burn now, so you're watching me play through Zelda, and it's gonna take maybe 4 hours. I'll probably do it in several sittings and just edit it all together. Alright. But in case you didn't watch my video, I like to explain things. Alright, this dude, if you place like a really lucky bomb, you can wipe him in one hit. So I'm gonna try and do it. I'm gonna try and place a bomb right in the middle of him and hope it goes off when he's nearby and it can destroy all his sides. Otherwise you need to break each one of his mouths individually. So let's and he moves kinda randomly, it's kinda hard to do, but it's cool when it happens. I thought it was gonna be really cool. Whatever. And you know, obviously he gets faster as you break his mouths. So it becomes more dangerous. You risk losing more health. Yeah, that's a big deal. He's a, you know, fairly easy dude. And look how decked out I am. But imagine if you came in here with like, you know, 3 or 4 hearts, and you came in here with like the green tunic still. No rings. I mean, he could really kill you. This guy could wipe you pretty quick. I just drank some water. Pro tip, stay hydrated. Okay, now we've got the raft, which will open up dungeon 4 to us. And it allows us to get one more heart piece on the overworld. But before I go for that heart piece, let's go to dungeon 4 and clear that out. What do I need rupees for? Oh yeah, potions, arrows, and a big shield, optionally. I think the big shield makes dungeon 6 easier later in the game. Dungeon 6 is a giant pain in the ass. I hate dungeon 6. And I normally don't buy the big shield, but let's see if it makes a difference. My only concern is that some enemies in the game can eat your shield, and I don't want that to happen. I feel like it's a waste of money that way. Alright, dungeon 4. I think a key will drop if I kill all these dudes. Yes, extra key. Okay, remember the gels from the last dungeon? I said they split if you hit them with a weak sword. These guys are the same way, but you need the master sword to stop them from splitting, which I don't have, so the hell with them, right? I skipped that locker room earlier because my memories from this game are telling me that I don't need to go in that room. That's really what I'm going off of. If you've never played this game before, you know, crack open some maps. You'll find a lot of neat stuff. It's really cool to look at the overworld in all its detail and all its glory and see, like, all the hidden rooms. Because honestly, like, a lot of their hiding places is bullshit. How are you supposed to find a lot of those trees you're supposed to burn down, you know? A lot of those walls you're supposed to break. Or, you know, blow up. You know, how do the developers intend for you to find that stuff? Without just, like, tons and tons of trial and error. I say, get a cool map out. Go for it. Look at everything. By the way, the candle here illuminates these rooms. Alright, I need to go through the door here. Do you see, like, that little water channel just above me? I can't cross that without this dungeon's item. And lucky for me, I was hoping that fire would kill all those bats. You can only use the blue candle once per screen. So I've already used it. I can't use it again until I move screens. Yeah, so lucky for me, here's dungeon 4's special item. It's a little ladder that allows you to cross little bodies of water. Gosh, they're supposed to be snake-like piles, but they look like piles of, like, crap, literally. These things can eat your big shield. If you spend the 90 rupees and buy the big shield, if you get hit by these guys, they can eat them. And it's a waste, you know, though, there goes 100 bucks, you know, it's gone, you'll never get that back. So that's why I'm always hesitant to get that big shield. I'd feel bad if I lost that much money. Although I've got a lot of money right now. I need to spend it on specific things, though. So, here's the raft. No, I'm sorry, I said raft. That's, the ladder. The ladder will give me access to the overworld's last heart piece. So I can get 2 more now that I have these items. Of course I want to complete the dungeon first though. I should have left one of these guys. Remember I told you before if you leave one dude they won't respawn properly? Totally missed that. Like, I'm gonna kill them all, it's gonna be cool. I'll say look at that guys. It didn't happen. So if you don't go into the rooms you don't have to go into, you can save those keys. And you'll need to go into this one. As a matter of fact, I'll show you what was in that room. I bet it was a non-access kind of deal. Yeah. See, had I gone into that room, it would be just a dead end, a waste of time. Here's the map. It's the piece of pumpkin pie, because it's orange. Does the map loosely resemble E.T.? You know, each one of these maps, if you look at the structure of the map, it's supposed to be an animal of some sort. Sometimes it's like a Nazi swastika. But this one kind of, I mean, if you use your imagination, I can kind of see E.T. I don't know. Here's Dungeon 3's boss again. It's cool they reused them. Alright, again, a well-placed bomb will kill him completely! Oh, I got 3 that time. Better than last time, right? Easy. Easy with the gear I have. Hard otherwise. Okay, there's a waterfall somewhere. You can walk into it. It's stupid. Okay. This. No, please. I don't know what I'm calling on. You can illuminate the room, but if you kind of know what you're doing, if you kind of know what's happening, you don't need to. Like, there's a block right here that you can't get through, and I knew about it, so it was cool. Alright, one more time. We need to wipe all these enemies. Let me get my candle, because I'm going to wipe them all in one shot. Yeah, that was kind of cool. Oh, that was really cool. We push this guy, and then we get the boss. So Dungeon 4 isn't hard. When you know what you're doing, even if you don't know what you're doing, a little bit of experimentation, it's not bad. When you break their heads, they spawn like these little soul things. So you just gotta drop that guy as fast as you can. If you try and dodge, the longer you're in that room, the more damage you're gonna take, naturally. So just wipe him. And then again, it's especially easy. It's especially safe if you've got all the gear I do. I'm up to like 8 hearts now. I can collect 2 more, and you could regard this as kind of a waste of time. Cause why don't you grab the hearts when you're at a more opportune place? Well, I'm gonna grab them now. It's a little out of the way, but I want them. I want to look like I have a lot of hearts on my health bar. I feel accomplished. Anyway, the trouble is it's on the far east side of the map. The 2 heart pieces I'm talking about. So I gotta walk over there. You know, this map isn't terribly big. There are some games that are just like, they have so much detail, they're so huge. And this map isn't huge. You know, I think a lot of things about this game are just right. Just the right number of tricks. Just the right map size, just the right number of enemies. It doesn't feel bloated in any way, you know? What a well-done game, honestly. 1986, by the way, 1 year after the North American NES launch. Let me go around this way. I'm gonna zip around down here, maybe get some arrows. So early in this console's lifespan, and they come up with this gem of a game. It's brilliant in its design and stuff. I mean, I have some minor qualms about how, you know, the way they hide things, how it's kind of unfair, but besides that, honestly, okay, we're on the far east side of the map, and there's this, I mean, you can see my position, you kind of get an idea of where I'm at. There's this little cave here, and here's where they sell the arrow. I think there's one more cave like this, one more shop like this where they sell an arrow, but this one's kind of on the way, and I talked about this in my video, so if you need a recap. Thanks, bro. I can't use the arrow yet. It'll appear in my inventory all by itself, but I need the bow to fire it from Dungeon 1. So there's this heart, which we need the ladder for. Boop, 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 got it. You see how my health bar is kind of like cycling over that way, wrapping over. Wrap is the word. That's cool, I feel accomplished. Alright, then you use the raft here. And here's the other heart piece. So now there's not a whole lot more to do on the overworld. I can still get the Master Sword. There are still more trees I can burn out if I want more money. more shops and stuff. There's a wrist a bracer thing that allows me to push heavy rocks. But there's not a whole lot more to do. You know, I'm nearby dungeon 2. I was gonna go to 1, but I don't feel like it now. 1 was close to 4, so when I first got out of 4, and I'm like, you know, I shouldn't go get those heart pieces right now. I could have gone to 1 at that time. But now, let's go to 2. It's right here. And you don't need any particular items to pass 2. Some dungeons you need, I mean, it's like it'll be really helpful to have a candle, or you need to have the ladder. But dungeon 2, it's very straightforward. Okay, it's right over here. Zelda, Legend of Zelda on NES, was the first NES cart to have a battery backup system where they have volatile memory inside of the cartridge, and they keep it lit up, they keep it energized with a battery, with a tiny little battery. Because, I mean, in the 1980s, we didn't have any cool technology to like, you know, just on the fly save data. I mean, you know, we had these ROM chips that these games are stored on. I think there's another key over here. But you can't erase the ROM chips in a practical way and, you know, rewrite them with save data. Not with the NES, anyway. So it was kind of clever having this memory. Volatile memory is memory that loses its contents when it loses power. Your computer's RAM, actually the NES's RAM, you know, it's like that. But it's really easy to write to. It's really easy to, you know, to put information on. Where, like, you know, the ROM chips, those are a huge pain in the butt to flash them and stuff. You need the right equipment for it. So to put volatile memory on a cartridge, you know, it's a cool idea. One of the problems it poses, though, is that later, you know, the battery could eventually run out. Actually, they can last 10 years easily. Here's my blue boomerang. I just gotta kill these dudes for it. But a lot of these old games... Oh, dear. Can I get out of here with full health? A lot of these old games, nowadays, if you still have the original batteries inside of the cartridges, they could be dying. They won't store your save information anymore. Although you can, you know, if you're not running an emulator and you actually have the cartridge, you can replace the battery. And in most cases, it takes, like, a little bit of soldering skill, which actually I don't have. I've never soldered anything before. It'd be cool to do, though. I've thought about, you know, changing the batteries to my cartridges. You can still buy the batteries and stuff. We haven't obsoleted the battery technology. Almost there. Alright, bombs will spawn in this room when you kill all these dudes. And I'm gonna use bombs, coincidentally, to beat the boss. And when I do, then I'll go back room and collect any bombs I've used. So I'm gonna leave them there. Alright, you can drop a bomb right in front of his face and he'll eat it. And I think you need to drop, what, 2 to kill him? But there's also a way to, like, drop a bomb underneath him, and when he gets into the smoke, it'll make him vulnerable to, you know, killing with a sword. I explained all this in the video. So there's a more surefire way, but you'll use more bombs. Anyway, since I have bombs down there... Done. I'm gonna burn the 2, I'm gonna be a little inefficient. Come back here, grab the bombs I used, and I'm full again. You know, it's not a big deal. I don't need to have 8 bombs for any given dungeon, but... What the hell, right? Might as well be efficient. Okay. Ugh, tired. Dungeon 8 is nearby, and by golly, I might be able to do it right now with the current items I have. Maybe. Maybe. Dungeon 8 has a key in it, and the key gives you, like, unlimited door access. So, like, I have 6 keys now, but every door I go through, every locked door I go through, it'll burn a key. But there's a skeleton key in Dungeon 8 that'll open any door as many times as you want to. Which is kind of cool. But, you know, I don't remember it well enough. I'm just kind of like, I'm musing to myself right now. I don't quite remember it well enough. I don't know if it's a good investment right now. It's just beneath, it's just to the south. It's like two screens to the south of me. Let's not do it though. Let's just do it in order. I'm gonna play this game safe. I don't wanna like dead end somewhere and oops. Okay, let's backtrack a whole lot. I mean, it's gonna be a long enough video as it is. That's my main concern. Now, if you're screwing around and you wanna see like what the most extreme dungeon is you can do early in, I mean, go for it, sure. If you die over and over, you know, whatever. Dungeon 6 will kill you over and over if you want one to die in. But I'm just going really safe. That's the reason I got all these hearts early in. That's the reason I have this blue tunic. We're playing safe. So dungeon 1. I talked about this in my video. It's here, across the bridge. Probably the easiest dungeon. And I've got, look at me, I'm walking in here with 6 keys. And here's another trick. You can leave the dungeon, you see this door above me? You can leave the dungeon and then re-enter it, and the door will be unlocked. So that's another key I saved. Like, how many games can you take, you know, items like keys and just bring them to other dungeons? Surely not Ocarina of Time. You use every key they give you in Ocarina of Time. But if you're smart and you kind of do what you want, you know, you don't have to use every key. If you feel like exploring more in depth, go for it. You're not always properly rewarded, you know. Sometimes it's like, oh, a room full of enemies. Oh well. Actually, I got so much money now too. Dungeon 1, those stealthos, those skeletons right there, they have a fairly high chance of dropping like a lot of money, and so do the snakes in dungeon 2. So like, you know, these guys can possibly drop blue rupees. We're like few other enemies in the game. So here's one right here. Few other enemies can. So dungeon 1 and dungeon 2, those are both kind of the bank. I mean, I guess you're sort of robbing the bank, I don't know. But you can walk out here with a lot of money. I can save another key if I go up here. Okay, here's the pumpkin pie is what this looks like. Does anyone else think that looks like pumpkin pie? And like years later, after playing this as a kid, I was like, oh, those are notes? I had no idea. That's called 10 keys for a moment there, 10 keys. And on that same note, you know, I have so many now, I'm just gonna skip these dudes. I wish I had a cool place to use them all. I wish I was like, okay, you know, I'm saving all my keys for this one dungeon where you really need them. I don't know, I like saving keys. I don't really have a plan for them. This really open design, the way Zelda is, it sort of carries over to Link to the Past on Super Nintendo. Part of the game is kind of scripted, it's kind of linear, and then like the second half of the game is just totally like, go do what you want. Not in the same way Zelda 1 is. But yeah, and then after Link to the Past, I think with like, a year later was Link's Awakening on the Game Boy. That's all, you know, heavily scripted, and Ocarina of Time is heavily scripted. You have to do everything they tell you to. Majora's Mask, like, if you don't want to complete the side quests, then you just don't have any hearts. You don't have to. The first one. Boomerang. I've already got the blue boomerang. It's the better boomerang right here. So I don't need this, but it's cool, right? But these early games, go do whatever you want. You feel like beating the late dungeons? Go for it. Yeah, which is just super cool. These hand things, they're part of like the rupee group where they drop a lot of money. See that blue rupee just dropped? Here's another one. But if they grab you, they'll take you back to the beginning of the dungeon. So you gotta be very very careful when you're fighting them. All right, this dude. He's easy, especially with like the fully powered up health bar. I can fire my swords. 3 hits with the white sword. The preference of racists. Or Donald Trump supporters. That's a good one too. I'm gonna write that down. If you don't have the white sword early in, you can use, you know, you can drop any bombs you might have. The bombs do a lot of damage to that guy. As a matter of fact, I think bombs when they explode, do the same amount of damage as... I think they're more powerful than the light sword. Alright, what do I need to do? I'm on 4. I need to beat 5. I could do 6, but no, I don't feel like it. I need 5 to get to 7. I can do 8 if I felt like it. Yeah, 5, sure. It'll give me the whistle. So let's do it. I think you need the ladder from 4 to beat 5, but we've got that. We're cool now. And I think there's, yeah, the boss of 5, and I think you'll meet him again in other dungeons, is vulnerable only after you blow the whistle. Alright, so I'm in this maze. It's not really a maze, it's like this weird loopy place. If you go to the right, it takes you back to the exact same screen. And likewise, if you go down the ladder here, it's not a ladder. Same screen, and you can exit the little loopy maze by going left. Now the trick to solving this is you just need to keep going up, like 4 or 5 times. 1, 2, and this will take you to dungeon 5, 3. How would you know this? If you didn't have like a walkthrough or someone didn't tell you, oh, maybe 4. How do you know you're supposed to do that? It's unfair. Again, there's no one that hints it. I don't know. Let's just go up. Oh, this is a dungeon. That's a good one. This is a dungeon where you can buy more bombs. You can expand the maximum capacity of bombs. And you know, I have so much money right now. Let's do it. Of course, I need to find the NPC for it. I think he's behind a wall. I might need to find a map. I forget where he's at exactly, because I don't normally do this. I don't want to spend the money because I'm a miser. Okay, there's a wall here you can bomb. I know, I can use my candle. I don't feel like it, though. And I think there's another wall here you can bomb. As a matter of fact, the mummy dude, he's encouraging it with his bomb. You can see it. I'll kill him later and get more bombs. Alright, we're going into the loot part of the dungeon. That's where this is leading. By the way, before you can move these blocks, you need to kill all the enemies on the screen. These are blue knights. I think they're a little faster, and they have more hit points, and they hit harder than their orange counterparts. These rooms where you need to kill these blue knights, they can get very tricky. They can get very tricky. Like, occasionally the AI feels like it knows its vulnerability from the sides, and as soon as it lines up with you, it'll turn really fast. And if you don't have full hearts, you need to be, like, right in front of it to do, you know, to land the blows. So, yeah, this room, again, I'm well equipped. I have a lot of health. I got my blue ring. I got my white sword. Preference of racists. So it's not a big deal to kill these guys, but imagine if you had the wooden sword going through here. Oh, gosh. That would be a hard room to fight through. But anyway, I'm okay. It's cool. Alright, over here, the flute is to the left. Let's grab that first. I'm pretty confident that's where it is. Yeah, well, I've got more of these guys to push through. Ooh. And then also in this region of the dungeon, go, you jerks. There's also the bomb expansion salesman. And I think I need 100 rupees to do it. But I've got so much money. And if you ever need money in the future, you know, re-clear dungeon 1 and 2 again. Those can, you know, you'll easily get 60 or 70 bucks per run. Ah, you jerk. So let me get that heart. I'm gonna refill my health. Nope. Oh, you see him doing it? It's like he knows to charge right into me when I get close by to him. I think I've lost a lot more health this time around than that last room. Oh, heart, sweet. Ah, good, thank you. I've got so much health now that those fairies don't even refill it all anymore. Isn't that cool? So much health, a fairy can't even refill it. So we got the whistle. On the overworld, you can blow the whistle, and a little tornado will come get you, and it'll take you to like one of your dungeons you've already beaten. That's kind of neat. Some enemies in this game will die will become vulnerable once you use the whistle. That's kind of neat too. So I'm compensated the key I just used to give in here. I like having a lot of keys. And then one of these walls is not like the other. Let's go... right?
No, you're doing it wrong.
Oh no, sweet. I bet you'd like to have more bombs. No, I would. You bet right. So, I have four more bombs than what they give you at the start. 12 bombs is a lot. There's one more, I think at Dungeon 7? There's one more bomb upgrade. So you can get 16 in total. But I think, you know, even 8 is enough to finish the game. But if you want to be cautious, if you want to be absolutely sure that you have all the bombs you need, yeah, go ahead and get the upgrades. Like, I might not even look for the one in 7. For one thing, I don't know exactly where it's at. And I'm gonna spend my money, like, on other things. 12 bombs is a lot of bombs. We'll say that. Since I'm full, I'm gonna ignore those mummies. I know one had bombs in it, but I don't need it. I left one guy in here, so naturally only one guy spawns. Had I killed everyone, I need to fight them all again. Oh. Another thing here, you're like, oh, look at these bosses. I gotta fight them all. I'm gonna fight all these bosses. You don't need to. Which is, I mean, a little misleading. Why are all these dudes in here? I mean, but you would end up using a lot of bombs doing that. So it's fitting that they give you the bomb upgrade here. These guys are part of the rupee group, so you see they're dropping like a lot of blue rupees. More mummies. These guys have a lot of hit points. I think they're part of the bomb group. They'll drop bombs. They're ready to drop bombs. Like from that one Eminem song. I don't know where I'm going. Hope this is the right way. These knights can't hit you when you're over the red water? I don't know what this, like the pit? I don't know what that is. But I don't need to fight them, so I'm gonna ignore them. Sweet, another key. 8 of them. These dudes, did I get the arrows earlier? These like little bunny things, they're very vulnerable to arrows. So we just died instantly there. But when you're stabbing with your sword, 5, you have 5 stabs with the white sword. I mean, even racists have a hard time against those things. Whenever you fire an arrow, it uses 1 ruby, which isn't a big deal. I think overall, it's as, like every arrow shot is as powerful as the white sword. For you racists out there. But I don't like firing arrows a lot, because it wastes money. It's just as good as the sword I already have. Now here's a room. Ah, yeah. Dear. Ow. What a waste.
I wasted 1 rupee.
Oh, you know, here's the worst part. Here I'm killing all these dudes. The door's just locked with a key. What a dum-dum. So here's the boss. This guy, this spinny, he looks like a big saw blade. He becomes vulnerable when you blow the flute. Come here. But he gets real fast, kind of like the third dungeon boss. Real fast, so fast. Okay. Did I mention I was tired earlier? Nah, I'm okay. We're gonna be okay. You know, I've cleared out like half the game, and it's only like 50 minutes. Which I know if you're sitting down for 50 minutes and watching me play these dumb games while talking about racists and stuff isn't anyone's ideal afternoon. But you know, Crystalis, wasn't Crystalis 4 hours? I love Crystalis. I love talking about it. But I think that one took me 4 hours to beat. I'm two-thirds of the way through the game, it's only been 50 minutes. So I like, when you know what you're doing, you're rewarded. When you know where to go, when you know where the secrets are, the game's like, cool, here's a whole, you know, here's rewards, here's a lot of cool stuff. But when you don't know what you're doing, it's a giant pain in the ass. Where am I going? Let's go to 8. I've been talking about 8 this whole time. Let's do it. Let's do it for real. Could I buy anything? I could buy a big shield, maybe. I'm saving that for dungeon 6. I could buy a red potion with 2 full heals, which I'm saving for dungeon 6. I hate dungeon 6, by the way. I'm gonna keep saying it. I hate dungeon 6. You're gonna hate it too. Like, dungeon 8, I think, is maybe a little harder than 6. I'm sorry, the dungeon 9, the last dungeon in the game. We can't get into it unless we have all the, unless we have all the Triforce pieces. There's a thingy here. Let's invest in some red medicine. Do it now, forget about later. Yeah, dungeon 9's a little harder, but like, you expect it to be. It's the last dungeon. Now meanwhile, there's 6 just in the middle of the game, and you die over and over and over and over getting to that place. Let's do 8 right now, though. I love that I'm given the option to do this out of order. So cool. So cool. Okay, it's just beneath us. It's beneath me. And unlike most dungeons, there are actually 2... Well, I don't know, dungeon 1's kind of like that. There are 2 hidden items, 2 special dungeon items in here. One of them is the spell book for the magic rod, and the other one is the infinite key. And one of them is still, I forget which one it is, it's to the left. Oh, level 3 boss. I've got so many bombs now, what the hell, right? I gotta feel it. You know when you're trying to like get into a jump rope and people are like twirling the rope for you and you have to time jumping into it? I feel like I'm timing this. Oh, that was close. I'm not gonna waste another one, I'm just gonna cut him down.
But Agent Lozen, you have 11 bombs left. It's not a big waste.
I'm a miser. Got him. Cool. Alright, and then this... Is this the spell book? I think the spell book is easier to get than the... Oh, I got my bombs back. Oh, you know what? The spell is easier to get than the key. I think that's how it goes. These flashing enemies right there on the left side of the screen. Yeah, on the left. If they hit you, they'll like numb your sword. Never mind. They'll stop you from using your sword. See, I'm pressing A. You can hear it. I can't use my sword. Oh, there it is. It takes a few seconds to get it back. But if you blow the flute, it resets it. It's kind of a strange thing. Now these glowing things, they can't hurt you, which is kind of cool. But they're a pain in the butt, and especially when you're surrounded by enemies and you need to use your sword and you can't. But blowing the flute resets it. Pro tip, blowing the flute resets the sword. Which is super cool, honestly, super cool. Very neat trick. Very worth mentioning. Alright, so here's the first item. What is it? I think it's the spell book. Yeah, there it is. It looks like a Bible or something, I don't know. It'd be cool if there's more stuff in here. Like, if you could open the spell book and choose the spell you wanted. Of course, you can't actually use it until you have the magic rod from Dungeon 6. Ugh. But, yeah, it'd be neat if you could interact with it more, and then it would do more things than what it does. It adds like a little fire effect, which is cool, to your spell rod, to your magic rod. But who cares, right? It's neat, but I just wish there was more to it, because you know it looks cool. I'm inspired by the way it looks. It looks cool. All right. This is one of those rooms. I don't know where the layout. I don't know what's going on. I'm kind of getting stuck, and I should use the. Jerk. Should use the candle, and I'm not, because I'm stubborn, and I'm a miser. I don't want to use up all my fire. Ugh, I don't know what's going on. Okay. Another Dungeon 3 boss. Once again, though, the cool thing is, if you're paying attention to the room, you don't need to kill this thing. I don't even think it drops any keys or anything when you blow it up, when you kill it. So we're just gonna go straight north. Actually, for several rooms we're gonna do this. Remember I talked before in Gradius, my Gradius Let's Play, about the sprite limits and stuff, and what it does to the game? Well, Legend of Zelda isn't very good at dealing with lots of sprites. There are ways to circumvent that, which other games use, like, you know, flickering your sprites so your game doesn't slow down. But this game is not doing a good job. When I start killing enemies, though, the sprite count will go down and it'll fix everything, as far as lag goes. Now there's less of a chance it'll lag since I've killed these dudes. Oh, that is beautiful. I think they only give you like 4 or 5 health, but man, I'll take it. This is like bullet hell. I feel like I'm playing a Ikaruga or something. Ikaruga. What's that game for the GameCube? Bullet Hell? The Bullet Hell the Game, I think it's called. Sweet, a key. So we're gonna work our way north for quite a ways. And there's a wall I need to bomb through. I wish I had a map. I don't know, it's easier to tell with a map. I think it's further north than this. I hate these blue dudes. It's more just time consuming. They're not terribly difficult to deal with. Alright, now I think in here you go to the right, or maybe I go further north. Let's use a bomb. I'm gonna try, no, what? Shoot. Let's go north. I think this is what I want. Alright, cool. I think this is what I want. This dude, I suspect there's a trick that when you first walk in, you fire an arrow right away. No? Oh well. I think Dungeon 6 boss, you can kill like as soon as he spawns, if you fire an arrow like immediately. And then to the right is the... Yes, this is where the infinite key is. Getting my arrows back. Now once I've done this, it's just a matter of beating the last, beating the boss in this dungeon. With as many keys as I've accumulated, remember that time I had 10 in the first dungeon? I may not even really need the infinite key, the skull key, the dungeon, or the skeleton key is the word. But, you know, for completion, I want to show you guys. That's how I am. Here? Here. Cool. There it is. Looks like a little lion head. I think it is a lion head. That was cool. Alright, now in place of the 6 I ever had before, I now have an A, which means I can go through any door I want to without using any keys. Now, the question is, how do I get to the boss? I really don't even remember. I wish you can get, like, a magical arrow that doesn't consume... You know, I think it's through here. I have a feeling it's through here. I wish you can get a magical arrow that doesn't consume money when you fire arrows. That'd be another neat thing. Maybe that'd be one of the spells in the spell book. Just a thought. Because I hate... I hate spending that measly rupee, that 1 rupee. And I need that potion. Firing the arrows. And I realize it's not even that much money. But just the thought of it makes my skin crawl. Alright, I am... If I get hit one more time, which I very well could, I'm gonna blow my potion. There it is. I was like, I'm gonna impress him. I'm not gonna get hit. No, it happened. So this is happening. Cool. I don't want to use it again accidentally. The bombs, I don't know. Now watch, every one of these guys is gonna drop some healing items. Oh, I'm not gonna need that. I'm really upset now that I'd use that potion. I hate using money. Potion is money. I guess they're being kind of stingy with healing items. come on. What's that?
Oh.
Good. And I'm hoping I didn't waste my time just then. I think through here, yeah, it's a staircase, and this staircase kind of leads into the boss section of the dungeon, which is where I want to go, which is where I'm headed. More bombs. That guy's gonna be nice and he's gonna knock me through there. But I'll equip the whistle so that I don't lose my sword in the future. Oh, this is a arrow part, which I don't need to do, but I want to. I think I need to kill all these dudes, and then, yeah, the door opens, and now we're gonna be at the boss, I'm hoping? Okay, I can't see anything in here. Can I just go through the door? I think so. I've got a feeling that I'm supposed to blow up the wall back there. And I just goofed up. 10th enemy has the bomb. That's a super cryptic way of saying killing 10 enemies in a row will produce a blue gem, a blue rupee. But if you kill a 10th enemy with the bomb, it'll produce more bombs. But gosh, I mean, what a way to say that, you know, right? Right? Can I go through here? Yes, this should be the boss. Cool, cool, cool. Remember this guy from Dungeon 4? Well, he's back, but he's got more heads. Anyway, I'm much better equipped than I was even in Dungeon 4. I mean, in Dungeon 4 I could have taken this guy, and the way I was then. I've got so much life now. Plus I'm at full health, because I used that potion earlier. Again, you're going to lose more health if you're trying to avoid everything. So just drop that guy as soon as you can, as fast as you can. Alright, that's Dungeon 8. I love doing this out of order. What items did I need for that place? It was useful to have the flute to recover my sword. I needed Dungeon 4's ladder, and that was it. I beat the whole rest of the dungeon without any special items. So realistically, you could do this like really early in the game. Alright, now we're at a special time in a young boy's life. Where I have enough hearts to get the Master Sword. I needed like all but two, I said earlier, and I'm there. So dungeons 7 and 6 I'll be able to clear with the Master Sword, which is super cool. Very cool. Wish I had more money, because I need to restore that potion I used earlier. There's one. Maybe these guys will drop some. Hey guys, I could farm dungeon 1 and 2 like I described earlier. Would you like me to do that for a half hour, just running in and out of that dungeon? Wouldn't that be exciting? Alright, to get the Master Sword, you can go really far north and then west. It requires you to use the ladder to cross some water. But there's a super secret way to access like the Master Sword in dungeon 6 part of the map. And I'm gonna show it to you. Oh, two fairies. What are the odds? No, what are the odds? Tell me. Bombs? No. Alright, so we're gonna explore the Master Sword part of the map by using the super secret entrance, which is through this forest. The forest is on like the southwest side of the map. Also, the dungeon, I should explain. Not that it's necessary. This fairy will store all your health, so it's really cool to visit her before you start Dungeon 7. And Dungeon 7, which we haven't done yet, and we will, is right over here next to the fairy. One screen over from the fairy. You blow the flute. It dries up the lake. There's Dungeon 7. We're gonna come back, though. Oh yeah, there's also a tree here I want to burn down. It's only like 10 rupees, but what the hell, right? It's a secret to everybody. Cool, 100 bucks. Alright, now we're in the forest maze. Remember like Kokori Forest? Is that what it's called from Ocarina? You know, there's the maze part. I think it's partially inspired by this. Anyway, Just like earlier in the northern part of the map, no matter what direction you go, you're gonna get lost. You're gonna just wrap the screen over. You see what it's doing? You can leave the maze by going to the right. So I'm out now. But there's an answer to the maze. It's up, left, down, left, which is more confusing than the Dungeon 5 one. But it takes you over here. This is the secret entrance to the northwestern part of the map. I had to think about my directions. So I'm in the graveyard now. The graveyard is a cool place to farm lots of money, lots of items. I think these ghosts right here, they belong to the rupee group. Rupee group, that's what it is. And when you touch the graves, it spawns more ghosts. Fake ghosts, by the way. You can't kill them. See, it's not hurting them. But if you kill, it's like the master ghost, like I'm doing right here. Then all the other ghosts die. Now you can spawn more ghosts, you see? But you can't kill them now until the master respawns. So we're going to avoid that now. But if you want to farm a lot of money, you can just spawn a whole bunch of ghosts. Here's the master sword, by the way. And keep killing the master. There's a master in a dungeon using this, and once you kill that master, you can use the sword, right? Right? Come on, that's a really good localization. All right, so we have all the hearts we need. Bingo, master sword. We're now doing, I think, three or four times the damage as the wooden sword. Or I think twice the damage as the white sword. The white sword is a preference of racists, right? But what's the master sword? Like slavery, right? That's a racism thing. Anyway, I don't like that joke as much. A good way to keep track of the master ghost here is to stun him and then do things like this. Stun him, stun him, stun him. Alright, that's enough ghosts, I think. There's a limit. Yeah, I'm at the limit now. Ah! Good. Now, I need money for the meat. I need at least 2 meat, I think. And I also need money for a big shield, if I want to get the big shield. And I never really do. And I always complain about how hard Dungeon 6 is, but I'm pretty sure the big shield helps a lot in Dungeon 6. So the question is it worth farming all this? I mean, honestly, I think the shield is 90. Isn't that what it is? 90? And I think, like, the food is 60. This is gonna take forever. Should I just do Dungeon 6 without the big shield? Look how powered up I am. Even with all this power I have, Dungeon 6 is, like, the biggest pain in the ass. Get my ass kicked in there. Lost my super ghost. Whatever, let's just do it. Dungeon 6 is right above me here. The worst dungeon in the game. And I'll explain why. What if I went in there and I oh, you jerk! Oh, God. Yeah, what if I went in there and I beat it just like really hard? I just beat the hell out of it at half health. Damn it! That was my fault. I'm being stupid, and I was like, I'll get him, and I didn't get him. And he beat the hell out of me. Oh, thank you. So here's 6. What makes 6 hard? I can go through any door I want now without consequence. What makes 6 hard are these guys, these whiz robes. They fire that magic shit at you, and it takes out, like, maybe a life and a half, a heart and a half. Now, these guys are predictable, right? You see them spawn, they wait 3 seconds, and they fire at you. And if you're smart, you'll just get out of the way, you won't let them hit you, which is fairly doable. Aim at the eyes of Goma. I wish I knew what Goma was. Goma is the boss of this dungeon, but they're not going to tell you that. So thanks for the hint, old man. Senile old man. So those orange whiz robes, no big deal, right? You know, you can avoid them. They're really damaging, yeah, but that's your fault if you get hit. But there are blue whiz robes in this dungeon. I killed the master one. There are blue whiz robes who will just chase you down. They'll randomly jump around the screen. They'll randomly move here and there. And then whenever they feel like it, they blast the shit out of you. And they are much, much harder to avoid. Here is a, oh, I thought it was a boss. That's gonna get, like, something out. So, the blue whiz robes is what makes this dungeon unbearable. Because they're extremely damaging. And they're hard to predict how they're gonna move. And just everything about them is a giant pain in the ass. So, there they are, my friends. Look at him go. I think once he aligns with you, he fires his shots. So I guess if I can kill... What my strat's going to be is I'm going to kill the orange whiz robes to the best of my ability. Oh, get off. See, I would have just lost my shield there. I had about the shield. I'm going to clear everyone else off, and I'm going to very, very carefully pick off the blue whiz robes. Damn it. How many hits? Two? One? Is this guy fresh? Two? Oh, three hits with the Master Sword. What a guy. Alright, here's another room full of them. Another pro tip. I'm not gonna fight them. Go through. Ah! Dungeon... Oh, this is... He's his own dude. He's not Dungeon 4 or Dungeon 8. Because he has three heads instead of two or four. Which is kind of cool. No more whiz robes in here. Yeah, maybe the trick to this dungeon is just not fighting them. Oh. You know what to do here. Whistle. By the way, I think the big shield will block whiz robe bolts, whiz robe magic. Go. Come on, I'm having trouble here. But there are all these snake things that eat your shield. That, you know, I'm just afraid of. I told you earlier would have been eaten when that guy grabbed me. No, that's a problem now. Didn't buy it, you know. Okay, not gonna fight those dudes. Oh, cool. We talked about these guys earlier. Remember how they split into the red bats? With the Master Sword, they don't split at all. Super cool. More bombs. I guess he's got the guys of a bomb group. Only members of the bomb group can drop bombs. Here is the magic wand. This dungeon's hidden... Oh, man. Stop. No. Look at all the health they take. This is insane. Oh, no. I mean, before I die, I just want to get this level's item, the magic wand. I need to kill these whiz robes very carefully. And they put you in a room with the snake things that can eat your shield. They put you in a room with those spectral, glowy things that can, like, take your sword. I mean, this room is meant to destroy you. I can't stay lined up with them. This is kind of like the blue knight things. And you don't want to be aligned with them. You don't want to hit them right on. Whoops. And maybe I'm not going to the treasure. I think I've just moved to the boss side of the dungeon. I could kill the boss. And then just come back later for the loot. Optionally, I could just never get the loot. Which I wouldn't do to you guys. I'm gonna get all the loot. It's a non-essential item though. The wizard wand you don't need, especially if you already have a candle. I'm tempted to not get it because I mean look at all the health I've lost. I've been very fortunate to not have to use a potion yet in here, because mostly because of my whole like oh don't fight anything tactic. Like in here, no. That was my song I was singing you guys. I was hoping to get out of here without using this. Okay. Here's the boss, whose eye opens immediately when you enter the room. Oh, it didn't work. Hold on. If you fire an arrow as soon as you walk in, I'm pretty sure you can kill him. No? Oh well, I'll take it. Alright, so what am I gonna do? It would be unfair to you guys for me to not show you where all the loot is. So I'm gonna grab the Triforce. And then maybe I'll just, I don't know. Let's do it again. We're gonna run it again. I don't have any healing items this time. Shame. But I do have one more heart than I had before. Cool. Look at my inventory, by the way. Look at this. I've got all those passive items on the top. I've got all my active items on the bottom. I'm missing, what, 3 things, maybe? I got a lot of gear. Metal gear. No. Oh, killed the master one. Occasionally, like, a master guy will spawn on the screen, and if you kill him, all the rest of them die. These guys belong to the rupee group. So they're dropping all kinds of money. All the bats. Now, of course, if you were smart and you were using a map to get through here, you would know where all the loot was and stuff, and you wouldn't need to do the whole rerunning this dungeon. Especially with these whiz robes, I hate these guys. Everything has so many hit points, too. Oops. I need my sword. See, the orange whiz robes with the master sword, one hit, you know, no big deal. But the harder ones, which is the ones I'd want to kill in one hit, take like 3. These guys are monsters. Good, good. That was a good run. Good room. I need to reward myself for every room of these I do well on. Okay. Here's a room where I'm going to die very quickly, and I'm not going to fight in here. Good, the dungeon 4/8 boss is gone. Alright, I went down... Jerk. I went down here, which is what took me to the boss. So this time, pro tip, I'm not going down. I don't know. I feel like this could be it. No, don't do that. It'd be cool if these things had a cooldown, like they could only fire like once every 2 seconds. But no, these things are the most brutal monsters in the whole game. In this one room, I've lost like 5 hearts really quickly. Alright, please be the loot. Please, I can leave. Oh, yes. This would have been really easy to get the first time through. Had I known, this is really easy to get to. Here's the wand. Now, admittedly, the wand is cool. Especially with the spellbook. The wand will fire out some whiz robe shit. Watch. Huh? Cool. But then when it hits a wall or an enemy, it'll burn from the spellbook. That's what the spellbook does. So the combination of the two allows you to light up rooms, dark rooms, and you can also shoot things. Very cool. Very neat. So let's get out of here. I'm done with this place. It wasn't too bad. I did have to blow up a blue potion, but this place wasn't too bad. Uh-oh. To get back, it seems I have to kill all these dudes. Looks like the whiz robes are immune to their own magic. This is where I lose all my health. No, gotta stay positive. I'm gonna do well. No. Okay. Cool. Well, that went better than I thought it would. Alright, now we've only got Dungeon 7 to finish clearing. So, my time is at like 1 hour and 19 minutes. I could have this game beat within 2 hours. I've collected basically all the loot, all the gear and stuff you can so far. Even the stuff I didn't want to get. So you could do like a minimalist run of this game in probably like an even hour. If you knew what you were doing, where to go. And you didn't get any of the non-essential items. I'm not gonna get the big shield. I was able to get through the dungeon where I wanted to use it without using it, so I'm gonna save my 90 bucks. Kill that prick. I could use a red potion though, and I think there's a shop right up here. And I also need a meat, at least one meat. I'm hoping it's between these two. Bingo. Oh, there's another item I can show you up here while I'm at it. Sure. I don't think I'll need that potion for dungeon 7, but for dungeon 9, I probably will. At least one shot of it. Oh, I didn't show you. There's a lot of things I can show you. I didn't show you the transportation network. You see these like little structures of rock to the left? Once you have the bracer, which I'm gonna get in just a second, I think it's like right here. One of these two. Ah, there it is, the bracer. Now I'm stronger, I can push rocks, and I'll have access to the transportation network. And it quickly whisks you away to various places on the map. However, I suspect I need to clear all the enemies first before I can use it. So I'm gonna use this cool Dungeon 6 item to kill these guys from a range. Oh well. Here. Again, this is you need the bracer to move that rock. Take any road you want. It's the nature of Zelda. Do anything you want. These are random, I think. So let's go to the left one. Ah. You know, it's lucky I found this place. Because we're not far from the spawn, you know, from the beginning of the game. Just above me, there is a fairy that'll restore all my health. And I'm not really terribly far from Dungeon 7 either. So that's the ideal spot. Now again, in Dungeon 7, I'm pretty sure, maybe it was 6, and I didn't even explore it all the way. There's another dude who's like, hey, do you want more bombs? 100 bucks, please. But as you can see, I've only been using a bomb or two here and there. I don't feel like I need all 16. And I know I've been saying, I want to show you guys all the gear, I'm going to get all the stuff for you. But I'm not going to spend the money because that requires farming more money. So just believe me when I tell you, somewhere, one of these dungeons, there's a guy that'll sell you your 16th bomb. I don't need it. We're not going to grab it. If you're ever doing like a completion run though, you might want to consider grabbing it. If you ever want to have a save file where everything is totally filled out, you can brag to your friends. Hey guys, you know that 20-year-old game from 1986? Yeah, I beat it all the way, look. It's scary that, but like, the more time that goes by, the more obscure and old this game becomes. The more kids haven't played it. You know, they're like high school seniors right now who are like, oh yeah, I played Ocarina of Time, I know all about Zelda. Yeah, I'm a Zelda pro, I played Ocarina. And you're like, brah, I was like 40 years old when Ocarina came out. Oh, 60 bucks, I thought it was a little more expensive. I'll take it. Like, you know, when I was growing up, everybody's played this game. You know, when I was 10 years old, you can be like, oh, hey, have you played Zelda? Yeah, I played Zelda, I know what Zelda is. I hate Dungeon 6. Yeah, I hate Dungeon 6 too. But like, now it's like, oh, I hate Dungeon 6. What? Bruh, don't bother me, I'm playing Call of Duty. Oh, you don't know anything about this game? So like, even now, I mean, I'm nostalgic for this kind of stuff, but I love these old games. Here I'm still playing. Look at me, look, what am I doing right now? I'm playing Zelda. And the thing is like it grows more obscure the more time that passes, the more young people that are born and are growing up. Like the people who vaguely remember Zelda from their childhood. I'm sorry, like Ocarina of Time from their childhood. You know, they're high school seniors right now. You know, when I was 7 playing this game, those kids they won't be born for like 4 years. Gosh, I'm getting old. The more in depth I think about it, I'm getting very old. Bombs, sweet. Alright, Dungeon 7, I'm not like super familiar with, to be honest. So I'm gonna wander around, and let's hope I get somewhere. Here? I've got a feeling no. I'm picturing a room in my mind where you're supposed to bomb a wall, And that sort of, to me, will kind of unveil everything. But I don't know where that room is. And I don't know exactly where the item is. By the way, the item in this dungeon, again, it's a non-essential item, is the red candle. The red candle you can use as many times as you want to. Remember this dude? I was about to kill him, but I realized you don't need to. I don't care what he drops, I'm just gonna walk past him. And you know, these are more money, guys. A key! You might be able to bomb a hole in the wall in this room. Maybe, but I'm not gonna try. I wish there was a spell in the spell book that, allowed you to not consume bombs when you use bombs or something. That seems kind of cheap, like kind of imbalanced, but I don't know, it's what I want. In the tip of the nose? I don't even know what that means. Thanks, though. I appreciate that. Thanks, brah. Alright, I think I'm near the beginning again. So, let's go left here. I wasn't expecting a room like this. Maybe I need to bomb one of the walls in here. I was expecting, like, another door to the left. Because I'm right next to the entrance, and I've already found one dead end. I'll leave that there in case I need it later. Let's look at what I have on the map so far. I don't know. You know... Okay, look. I suspect maybe there's a bomb here. I'm gonna try it. Oh, good. And then the bomb I used will be replenished right now. I think they were encouraging me to bomb. That's what that bomb is for. The one that spawned. Right? I mean, I earned this door, right? I kill all the guys. Dead end. There's a compass, it looks like. I don't need it, but let's grab it anyway. With the Stealthos, I'm gonna earn money anyway, so... Yeah, this dungeon, by comparison, like, if you're doing them in order, and you just finished 6, and you're going to 7 now, you're like, wow, 7's so much easier. It doesn't seem right. It should be getting harder. And, I mean, it sort of does. Dungeon 8's pretty tough with all those blue knights. But 7, it's just not that bad, because there's no Wizrobes. Again, here's another room where you can optionally kill these dudes, but you don't have to. I recommend not doing it. Oh, bombs. Maybe I can bomb a wall in there. A key. Oh, these snake dudes, they're part of the money group. See the blue rupee? Okay, well. There might be a bomb a wall in there. I don't know. I don't care. If I get desperate enough, I'll go back and look. Ah, remember what I was talking about? I bet you like to have more bombs. Do I need any more money? I thought I needed another meat for Dungeon 9. I said no, we're not gonna do it. There it is, by the way. By these Triceratop things. If you want more bombs, you could buy it there. I can almost afford it, but I want to save my money. I don't want to farm at all in this game. Can you recall a time when I was really farming, when I was really intentionally redoing things over and over? I can't. I like to think my run is free of farming. It saves tons of time. I mean, you can farm, but I don't want to. One of these dudes, which I'm not gonna fight. Yeah, screw him. Here we go. This is why I bought the meat. Grumble, grumble. His belly is grumbling. But you give him the meat, he disappears. Now he's gone permanently. In this dungeon, you never need to give that guy meat again. So you don't need to keep buying meats over and over again for 60 bucks a pop. Well, there's the map. Yeah, I lost my sword right now, but I do have this. So that's cool. Here it is. Remember that room I was like, oh, I'm remembering a room where you need to bomb and it takes you to the boss? I think that's right in here. This is the layout, this is the room I remember. You need to bomb this wall, but I need to find the red candle before I move on to the boss. My whole completionist thing. No. Oh, I've got a feeling you're gonna bomb a wall here. Maybe not. You know, honestly, I don't remember where that red candle is. What's my map showing? Oh, it's very incomplete. There's a lot of rooms I haven't visited yet. I know, according to my map, you can see it. You can't go up, and I know you can go to the right from a different room, so the only wall you could possibly bomb is that one. But it didn't open, so I'm not gonna try anymore. I've logically concluded that there are no other walls worth bombing. Okay, now. Good. You can hear the cry of the boss. If you're like one room adjacent to the boss, you'll hear him like, bah, bah. But I'm gonna take these stairs and it's gonna take me somewhere else. Oh, I'm sorry, here's the red candle. That's cool. Well, you know, I thought this took me to the boss, and now it's just another dead end. Well, I'm glad I found the loot. Remember Dungeon 6 earlier, how I had to come back through the dungeon again to find the loot? Well, not this time. But I don't know where to go. I don't think you bomb your way into the boss room. According to my map, I haven't been down or to the right yet. You know, I've got a lot of bombs. Let's find out. Oh, yes, perfect. Good guess. Good guess, Agent Hosen. Now, like I said, the red candle you can use indefinitely. The blue candle is only once per screen, but the red candle, go for it. But it's like it's obsoleted by like the spell book and the wizard wand. Oh, they reward me for having done that. So really, you don't even need the red candle. If you were a minimalist runner, and if you knew where to go, you could just bypass the red candle completely. Let's go to the right. Oh, I finally have to fight this dude. Whistle. The Master Sword chews this guy up. Hold on. It looks like you need to fight everyone, but I should be able to bomb this right wall, according to the map. Bingo. And I think this is a stairwell? Oh yeah, there's a hidden stairwell in here. That takes you to the boss. I really don't want to grab right here. Alright, good. I've cleared all the enemies, and I can move this block over here. And there's a stairwell, which will take you right to the boss. So this dungeon wasn't hard. I didn't remember it well. I was kind of afraid it was going to take me a while to get through. And it kind of did, but it also kind of didn't. So, it's cool. Now, another thing. Well, what's in this blank spot here between these two items? For the life of me, I cannot remember. What goes here? What is this? I don't even know. Maybe I'll find it? Like, I know what loot comes from Dungeon 9, and I know none of that loot actually fills those spots. Am I missing something super obvious? Like an item I had earlier that I used up or something? The blueberry pie that I gave to the old lady. That is, that's underneath my potions. So when you use the potions up, you get the blueberry pie back. And you know, I don't remember what this boss is either. No, I think it's the Dungeon 1 boss again. Yeah. How many hits of the Master Sword? One, maybe? Two. I've got all the hearts now. Yeah, you know, I really don't even know what that thing is. Between here and here. I've got a feeling it's just something super obvious I got earlier, and I'm just totally, like, I'm blanking on it.
Cool, cool, cool. Oh, no, 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 remember? That's the meat. I bought it for $60 in the Blue Ring shop. That's what that is.
Stretching and moving around. Okay, we've got the whole Triforce now. I gotta drink some water. I've got all the items up until now. As far as completion goes, the only thing I'm really missing is the bomb upgrade from this dungeon. But just in case, and I think you need another meat for dungeon 9. So as I leave here, let's spend that money on another meat. That's why I didn't get the bombs, because I wanted to make sure I wanted to be certain I had the money to buy the meat, because I don't want to farm if I don't have to. And, you know, you could run through dungeon 1 or 2 and farm pretty easily. But I don't want to. We're going for efficiency here. Alright, let's do it now. I've got everything. Let's do it. Let's go to dungeon 9. Now, I showed you the back way into that place. Remember through the forest? Up left, down left? Let's go the proper way. In case you wanted to know, well, if you didn't do the forest, how would you actually do it, Brian? Well, I'll show you. I'm glad you asked. You know, I don't even really need the money now. Got everything a boy could want. I've got more than I could ask for. Only one? Stingy. Now, I did briefly do a little bit of research on this game before attempting this. By the way, here's the ladder part. So we'll go across, and this links to where dungeon 6 is. But, you know, I need to go up the ladder, I think. I did do a little bit of research on this game just to, like, reaffirm some knowledge I had. I wanted to make sure I knew how dungeon 9 flowed, because it is by far the most complex dungeon in the whole game. And when you know what you're doing, it's not terrible. But if you don't know what you're doing, you're going to spend a lot of time going in circles, and you're going to spend a lot of time in the dungeon. So here's dungeon 9, and I forget which rock it is. Good thing I have a lot of bombs. Here, the right one?
No, it's not! Don't bomb there!
Oh, look at that. The left one?
Yeah!
It's like a Nickelodeon, like, oh, hey guys, which bomb is it? The left?
No!
Alright, this room will, stop you. There's a if you don't have, I mean, you can walk in this dungeon anytime you want to, but if you don't have the complete Triforce, there's an old man right here who'll be like, hey, you can't get in here without the Triforce. So this is the thing that stops you. But since we have it, he didn't appear, we're good. I'm meditating. There are two pieces of loot in this dungeon, which only really happens once or twice in the whole game. I need to go this way for one thing. And I'm trying to remember if the loot is in the first, like, area A. Oh no, I don't want to fight in here. Or if it's in, like, area B. I know that the red ring, which is the first item in here, which, like, quadruples my green suit defense, is in the upper right corner of the map, the very most upper right corner tile. And I don't remember when you're supposed to try for it. You know what, you have to go this way. First of all, let's go this way, like I'm remembering. And let's see if it takes me to the upper right corner of the map. And if it does, we'll go from there. And if it doesn't, if I'm on, like, the far left, then we're gonna go back. I think it does. Yeah, do you see I'm kind of like in the upper right section? I mean, in the upper section anyway. So I'm gonna go to the right. I'm actually gonna walk right. In this dungeon, I mean, there are so many locked doors. It's so big, but since I have the infinite key, since I have the skull key, it's like, you know, no big deal, right? We're gonna walk to the right, around, get hit by that whiz robe that I ate. And then I think there's an old man nearby, and he's like, go into the next room. And that is that's the path. That's the actual path. Well, I need to kill all the little bugs on the outside first. Oh. Come on. There's one left. I think that means I can bomb that room. Or bomb this room. Alright, so this dude, yep, here's the old man. Going to the next room. He's pointing you in the right path. We're in section B of the castle. And section C you can access from right there. But actually, I think maybe in this room here is where my red ring is. But you can't access it from this room. So I'm going to go down one. Remember where they dropped the bombs, right here? I'm going to use this room as a starting point. Nope, maybe down one. There's a wall on the right that you can bomb. And I kind of vaguely know the details, but I know enough that I'm gonna be able to find it. Let's try this one. Yes. I'll go in here and then go up. Probably by bombing. Or maybe this is no, this isn't the room. I know it's in the upper right corner. Yeah. I'm gonna go up here. And then I think you can go up one more time. Hey, a room full of whiz robes. Lucky for me, I don't think I need to fight them. But despite them, I'm still getting my ass beat. Oh, beautiful. Please no way. Oh, man.
We're gonna get away without fighting him, guys.
Nah, that's not happening. That's okay. Oh, maybe it's not okay. No, I tried to hit him and I couldn't. Die. Okay, cool. Now this is item one from this dungeon. The red ring, which will, I think it doubles my defense again. So those whiz robes that were taking out huge chunks of my health, I'm red now, I'm like Mario, look, are now not going to be that effective, which is super cool. You know, before 2000, I never knew where this ring was. I knew it existed, and I knew you could grab it, and I knew people told me about it, but I didn't know where to find it. And, you know, I knew it was in this dungeon, I knew everything about it, except its exact location. Now, of course, when I played this a few years ago, I looked up a map, and I'm like, oh, there it is, cool, and I went and got it, so I have gotten it since then, but for a long, long, long time, I always beat the game with my blue tunic, with my blue ring. Alright, here's the go to the next room, dude. He's telling me that in the next room is part C. And it's accessible through here, which I have to fight whiz robes for. But they don't do as much damage as they used to, so I'm not as afraid of them. This red ring really does wonders. No, come back. Alright, we've killed all these dudes. We push this block, and here's part C of the dungeon. Part C has the second item in it. No, that could be part D. Part C has multiple branching paths that take you eventually to the item. Oh, nice, thank you. Oh, you go left from here. I knew because I looked at the map before I did this. There's a keys room. Remember, these guys are called keys, they're bats. And then this takes me to part D, where the, what's it called? The final item to this dungeon is. Stop! You're doing me a fright. Okay, now I'm going to, this is leading me to part D. Part C is where I need to go to get to the boss, though. So we're gonna come back to part C. So I'm in part D now. To get through part D, you bomb up like that. And then I need to wipe everyone in this room, which is easier said than done. Shoot, especially with those narrow corridors. Just die, just die, just die, just die. Please don't take my sword. Not right now. We're gonna push this guy. And down that stairwell there is the second item in this dungeon, which you need to find. You need to get this. The silver arrow, right? If you've played Link to the Past, you know that Ganon can only be beaten with the silver arrow. And it's the same thing for this game, too. So, silver arrow. Now, we're going to take a look at the item screen. This is all the items in the game. Right here is a totally and utterly filled out item screen. Cool, huh? So we're heading back now. We're in part D. We need to get back to part C. And you know what? I'm going to need to fight these pricks. Because I need to go... You can't push blocks unless all the enemies are dead. And I need to push a block here. It's cool I'm only losing like half a unit of health per hit. Alright, I'm not going to risk this. Let us use this expensive thing that I bought. The potion. And I told you you can refill a potion by buying another minor potion, another blue, right? I told you that? That's good to know. That's good to know. Cool. I'm going to beat this in sub 2 hours, guys. I mean, minus those bombs from Dungeon 7, this is a 100% run. If you don't count, like, and there are more trees I can burn down, there are more walls I can bomb on the overworld. It's just money, there aren't any actual items. Alright, now we're in part C again. This room is a very important room. Oh, I didn't buy the shield either, so it's not really, it's like 95% complete. You can make a mistake here. If you go up to the next room without killing all these worm things, all the snakes, you'll go into like this big, ugly, nasty loop. And you have to like you'll have to fight a ton more stuff. You have to kill a whole bunch more guys. And in the end, you'll just loop all the way around, and it's gonna suck. But if you make a left here, you're on the right path, and you'll very quickly come across the boss of this dungeon. I don't even need the money. So we're gonna go up here. Go up here. And this is a nasty kind of spiky room. Do it! Do it! I got so much health now, I got so much defense. Do it! Hit me! Sweet. Alright, now this takes us to part E. We're in C, we're going to E now. And in part E... You know, by the way, I should note that, like, no map, no strategy guide labels it E or A or what I've, you know, what I've been doing. That's just my own personal labeling in my head. So, like, don't look up an FAQ and type, Part E, where's Part E? They're not talking about it. Because that's just what I do. Down? Oh, no, I'm sorry. It's not down. I think you might be able to go down, and that's the wrong way. There's another stairwell immediately to the left, which takes me to Part F. Yep, here it is. And then no more stairwells after this. Once you get to Part F, you're at the boss area. You can see how this can be a confusing dungeon, though. Like, I've explicitly seen rooms and thought, no, I know where to go, or no, don't go this way. But if you didn't know to not go that way, if you didn't have a map, if you didn't have some kind of guidance, like, you'd be here for hours. You would die over and over. You'd burn tons of items. All right, we are basically there. So again, this game is hella unfair in a lot of ways, and I love it, but if you don't know what you're doing, you're not going to like this game, honestly. Okay, here we go. You see, look at my map, the big orange map in the middle. I've only cleared out like half the rooms in this dungeon. Like, the blue map in the bottom left corner is all the rooms, but I've only visited half of them. When you know what you're doing, it's not a bad dungeon. Here we go, guys. Final boss, Legend of Zelda. If you've never seen it before, here it is. That's Ganon. He turns invisible. He's literally jumping around the room. He's invisible right now. You can kind of tell where he is by where the fireballs are going. So, like, he's on the left. He's at the bottom. He's on the right. I just walked into him. He's on the right. On the right. So, you can kind of stab roughly where he was, where the fireballs are. See? And you hit him. And there he is again. You can't tell exactly where his location is, because he can fire from like any part of his body, I think. Maybe he's only firing from his head. Maybe. I don't know. But you want to swing your sword roughly where the fireball came from. But that means kind of walking into the fireball, and you're going to take damage, right? When he turns red, shoot him with an arrow. It's done. I got the Triforce of Wisdom. Well, you can't see it. That's in the overworld. And Ganon was holding the Triforce of Power. So this is the whole Triforce right here. Cool. And he's like this like bloody little pulp right here. He's this like little pile of gore. And then in here is my Princess Zelda, the titular character. Game is over. 1 hour and 50 minutes, that's The Legend of Zelda, guys. That's how you complete it. Kind of out of order, you know, but whatever. It's fun going out of order. That's one of the best things about this game, is doing whatever you want to, you know, whatever dungeon you want to hit. For the most part, I mean, there are some exceptions, but. I think Miyamoto might be that Miyahan guy, where the director is. Nobody uses their real names in these early games. 1986, by the way. It's an early Famicom Disk System game ported to the NES. If you press start, your little link icon on the start screen will have like a master sword, and you get the second quest. Interesting little trivia. I've never beaten the second quest before. I've looked at the maps and I thought, nope, 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 nope. And that was it. And I'm not going to, so haha. Hope you guys were hoping for that. Yeah, thanks for watching. I know this is another kind of long video, about an hour and 52 minutes. I thought I'd have to take a rest somewhere in the middle, and I really didn't. Great game when you know what you're doing. When you don't, it's a giant pain in the ass. And if you've never seen the ending of The Legend of Zelda, if you've never seen it and played through it, there it is. As always, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.